This episode is sponsored by Wix. Wix is a free, super-friendly website building platform that creates amazing professional-looking websites. Wix has tons of free, stunning templates to choose from, and each has the flexibility to customize it to your liking. And you don't need any technical or coding skills to do it. Click the link in my video's description below to start creating your own free, stunning website. Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly and easily create the look of a pencil portrait from a photo and how to replace it with other photos without having to redo the effects. This is an update of tutorials I did quite a while ago on earlier versions of Photoshop. This update is quicker, more flexible, and gives you results that are even better than before. Open a sharp, high-resolution, close-up photo of someone that you'd like to use for this project. It can be color or black and white. Let's check its size and resolution to ensure that your finished result will look similar to mine. Go to Image and Image Size. Make its resolution 150 pixels per inch and its height approximately 900 pixels. Its width doesn't matter. Next, we'll convert it into a smart object so we can adjust the filters at any time, as well as replace our subject with another without having to redo the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. If your subject is black and white, as in this example, the next step isn't necessary. However, if your subject has color, click the adjustment layer icon and click black-white. Hide the copy and make the bottom layer active. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Distort folder and click Diffuse Glow. Make the graininess 10, the glow amount 6, and the clear amount 4. Make the copy of the subject visible and active. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Go back to Filter and Filter Gallery. Close the Distort folder and open the Stylize folder. Click Glowing Edges. Make the edge width 1, the edge brightness 20, and the smoothness 15. We want to invert it. Click the adjustment layer icon again, and this time click Invert. Since an adjustment layer affects all the layers below it in the Layers panel, in order to restrict it to affect only the one layer below it, we need to make it into a clipping mask. To do this, either click the clipping mask icon or press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Another way would be to go to Layer and Create Clipping Mask. Make the Glowing Edges layer active and change its blend mode to Linear Burn. Reduce its opacity to 50%. Next, we'll add a bit of texture to our image, which will especially enhance the pencil effect on the white areas of our portrait. Scroll to the bottom and make the diffuse glow layer active. Go back to Filter and Filter Gallery. Close the Stylize folder and open the Texture folder. Click Texturizer and choose sandstone. The scaling is 100%, the relief is 4, and the light is from the top. I'd like to darken the bit tones a bit more. If you want to do this as well, scroll to the top and make the top adjustment layer active. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. Drag the mid-tone slider to the right until the mid-tones of your portrait are slightly darker. To replace your subject with another, make any smart object active and double-click it to open its source. To replace your photo, go to File. If you're working on Photoshop CC or later, click Place Embedded. If you're working on an earlier version, click Open. Find and click your new subject and click Place or Open. Place Embedded automatically opens your image using the Transform tool. However, in earlier versions, you'll need to manually open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If you want to make your new subject larger in your document, zoom out by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard a couple of times. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out or in. To reposition it, go inside the bounding box and drag your subject into position. Then press Enter or Return. Close the tab of the Smart Object, and when you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.